Welcome to clickmyproject.com. Let we discuss about the process online speech reverberation using Kalman filter and EM algorithm. Let me see the abstract of the process. The process of denoising input speech signals is more helpful in the process of providing efficient sound system. First adaptive Kalman filter is designed for the removal of the noises in the signals. Kalman filter includes two steps, the prediction step and the estimation step. In the prediction step, the noises in the signal were estimated. In the estimated step, the estimated noises in the images were removed based on the calculation of the amount of noise estimated. First adaptive Kalman filtering is employed for the removal of noise from the signal, which is based on the prediction and estimation of the noise level in the signal. The input speech signal is denoised with the help of fast adaptive Kalman filter. State transition and observation models need not to be linear functions of the state, but may be instead be non-linear functions. The functions can be used to compute the prediction state from the previous estimate, and similarly, the function can be used to compute the predicted measurement from the predicted state. The prediction and the estimation process are the steps in the Kalman filter. The nonlinear functions employed for the prediction and the estimation process improves the performance of the prediction adaptive Kalman filter process. The nonlinear functions defined for the Kalman filtering process is designed so that the process is reduced in iterations and more adaptive. The signal subspace algorithm, which identifies the maximum level of the noise in the input signal and the removal of the identified noise level, is employed. The filtered signal and the original signal is then compared in order to measure the performance of the process. The performance is measured with the help of performance metrics like SNR, DRR, LSD, SRMR and WSIRIN. Let me see the flow of the process. Input signal is obtained from the data set. The noise is generated and the noise is added to the input signal. After that, we obtain the noisy signal. This noisy signal is then used for the process. The first step is the fast adaptive Kalman filter. Kalman filtering consists of two steps, prediction and the estimation step. In the prediction step, the noises in the signals were predicted. The prediction step is estimated based on the identification of the noise location in the signal. In the estimation step, the predicted noises were updated by updating the prediction noise levels. The Kalman gain is estimated using the predicted and the estimation step. The prediction and the estimation steps were both repeated till the number of speech samples in the input signals. The threshold range for the identification of the noise is estimated. After that, we move on to the signal subspace algorithm. In the signal subspace algorithm, the high-level noise locations were estimated and they were subtracted from the input signal. The high-level noise locations in the input signals were identified by the calculation of the difference between the input signal and the estimated noises. The different subspace of the input signal is identified based on the different equivalent subspace of the input signals. The identified subspace of the signals is called as the single subspace algorithm. The identified values of the subspace identified is the maximum ranges for the noises. The identified noise locations were then removed from the signal, obtaining the filtered signal. Finally, the performance of the process is measured based on the performance metric. The performance metrics like SNR, DRR, LSD, SMSR, WSIRIN were measured. And The performance values indicates that the proposed approach is improved compared to the other existing approaches. Let me see the running procedure of the process. If you want to run the code, select the file main.m which is present in the source code folder. Right click it and click on a run file. You will get the process executed. First select any one of the signal which is present in the data set. The process will execute. This is the input speech signal that we have selected from the data. This is the noise added input audio signal. So the noise is generated and it is added to the input signal producing the noisy audio signal. This is the adaptive Kalman filtering process which indicating the actual state, estimated phase and the changed frequency of the input speech signal. This is the resulting denoised speech signal. This is the part of a speech. This is the spectrogram of the input signal. This is the spectrogram of the noised signal and this is the spectrogram of the output speech signal. These are all the performance measures estimated for LSD, WSIR, SMSR values for the input signal, output signal and their differences. And this is the SNR value of the process estimated. Thus, we have identified the noise in the input speech signal and we have filtered this signal resulting in the denoised speech signal. The performance of the processes were measured and they were displayed here. Thank you.